So the migration to testing. So first, some basics about distributions actually suits. So packages are normally uploaded to unstable. One of the exceptions is, of course, that the package is not ready, it's not release quality, you should upload it to experimental. After some rough testing on unstable, they normally migrate to testing, and from time to time, testing is declared stable. And that's what we call release. And as I said before, experimental is for packages that are not of release quality. So we have testing from unstable to migration from unstable to testing. The packages are only considered after a certain amount of time. Considered doesn't mean that they will move after that time. They also have to be in sync on all architectures, all release architectures. So that's ARM, AMD64, MIPS, MIPSL, PowerPC, Spark, S390, i386, i64. And I might forget one. At the moment, they also shouldn't have more release critical bugs and unstable than in testing. We are thinking of changing that to there shouldn't be a new RC bug in unstable. And one of the things that most people don't know, but which also is a factor, is that they shouldn't break packages in testing. So when does a package break? Well, if it's not installable anymore. So that can mean that there's a new conflict or that the package needs a new version. So if when the package would transition to testing and the package itself or other packages wouldn't be installable anymore, there would be no transition. Then there is also the migration from testing for post updates to testing. All these migrations need manual handling from the release team. So they need approval. And they also shouldn't break any packages. So even if they are approved manually by the release team and they would break packages in the testing, they wouldn't migrate. So urgency of the upload is no factor if you upload to trust testing proposed updates. Only the manual approval and the installability is a factor. So also in sync, being in sync on all release architectures is to manually check by the release team. So, a little bit more about these factors. You have the urgency of the upload. Normally you use normal, of course. So that means the package has to wait 10 days in unstable before it's considered. So, then you have medium. So if you want to transition faster, you use medium. Then high is for packages that are only considered after 2 days, and critical for 0 days. Of course, critical is not to be used except in really rare circumstances. Then being in sync on all release architectures, so that means they have to be built normally on the build teams. But not only build, they also have to be uploaded, and even that is not enough. They have to be installed in the archive. The difference is sometimes you can upload a package and it gets rejected or it doesn't move, well, for whatever reason, from incoming to the archive, so then it's not in sync. So, and as I said, it shouldn't have more RC bugs in unstable than in testing, otherwise it won't migrate. So that means that at least an equal amount of closed and new RC bugs. So it can be that you have a new RC bug and you close RC bug. At the moment it would move to testing, and we are thinking of changing that, that it can only move to testing if there are no new RC bugs in our state. So that's actually about the next sentence of the slide. New in testing is no RC bugs. So if a package is not in testing and it has to migrate for the first time to testing, it shouldn't have any RC bugs. And of course it's always better to have less RC bugs and not an equal amount. So, not breaking packages in testing, so it's about installability. And one of the things we sometimes see is that packages depend and conflict at the same time on another package. That is, of course, not installable. And some maintainers do that to with meta packages to make sure that the old version is removed and the new is installed. But then you can't install the meta package from scratch, so then it's not installable and your package won't migrate. So that also means that all dependencies of the packages should be installed. And for some library transitions, then if a library transitions and it has another subnet, things like that, then, of course, many packages are not installable with the new version because they haven't migrated to the new library version. So they should all enter at the same time. So that was in short like what normally happens when the release team doesn't hint any packages. Of course, the release team can decide about removing packages from testing. Then we use the removal hint, of course. And we can also block packages from entering testing, even if they are ready to migrate. Or the other way around, if some packages are blocked, like say in a freeze or because of UDEPs or things like that, we can unblock the package. So blocking and unblocking is only about is actually a new factor. So the four first factors still remain the same. If it's not installable, it won't migrate, even if we unblock it. Then you can always force packages into testing. So then the four factors don't count anymore. We just say it has to go to testing no matter what. You can say, why do we need hints in the first place? Because normally there shouldn't be any problem. Well, some packages depend on each other. And if they depend on each other, then at the moment in Brittany, every package is tried on its own to migrate to testing. So the four criteria are need to be checked for each package on its own. So if a package A depends on package B, and package B is not in testing, well, it can't migrate. But if package B also depends on A, then B can also not migrate. So we need a hint to say they have to move together. And that's we can allow packages with cyclic dependencies to enter. We can also change the urgency. Well, not really change the urgency, but we can say set H days. And H days, then we decide like it has still to be like, for instance, H days 8, and then it has to be 8 days and stable before it can reach test. So we can actually take any number we want. Any number of days. Then there are of course some issues. Like I said before, when a library transitions, packages can stick together. And that's even worse if more than one library transition is going on and packages depend on more than one library that is going to transition. And of course, if they are not built on all architectures, or if there are built-in issues or failed to build from source, but it can really be a pain to have them transition to testing. So then we sometimes force the removal of a package from testing to make sure many other packages can enter test. And of course, if for some architecture packages are not being built because of slow build teams or whatever, then the risk of having more and more packages to be that more and more packages need to enter testing at the same time will be higher. So one of the strategies we use is of course to discover these things too. It's not that difficult to discover them because we have Bjorn who has a nice page to see what packages need to go in and together and why they are not moving to testing and things like that. Of course, we try to avoid these library transitions, so we really want maintainers to inform us if they upload a library transition. In worst case, we do binary use, but actually that's not worst case anymore because there are that many uncoordinated uploads that it happens a lot. And we try to coordinate with build the maintainers and FTP masters to make it go more smoothly. So, as I said, for the maintainers, we really want that there are never packages uploaded into unstable that are not meant for the release. So actually that means don't install and don't upload packages that are not of release quality. Upload them to experimental, but not to unstable. Because they interfere with library migrations, they interfere with everything that has to migrate to test. And please look at the package migration status before uploading. So that's the same reason, otherwise it can interfere with migrations that are almost ready and then they are reset. So then the migration has to wait longer. And of course, if it has to wait longer, there's a bigger, a higher risk of other packages that are also uploaded that make it even more longer. So I do hope that people know more about testing migration and what the issues are. And Yeah, he has already addressed.
So one thing that I think many people are...
One thing that many people seem to sometimes feel is that the FTP masters are trying to stop their packages and that they're trying to push them. And I just wanted to kind of undermine this sentiment. It's obvious from your talk that there are ways for the maintainer to bypass the, for example, the normal testing migration procedure by abusing the urgency and so forth. So would you agree with me that maintainers ought to talk to you and maybe ask for exceptions and so forth when it seems appropriate?
Yes, sure. Maintainers should talk to us if they want exceptions, sure. If they misuse the urgency and we see it happening before it's too late, before it has migrated to testing. Why need packages to wait that long and then stable actually is just to make sure there is some testing of the packages. So if some maintainers want to circumvent that by just misusing the urgency, we will of course set the H days to track 30 or 20 or something like that. And talk to the maintainer why he did that. So it's better if the maintainer asks beforehand for an exception, then we can be reasonable.
So from your talk, it's not really clear to me if bin and the new is something that you as a release manager like or not, because in the past I used to do not like them, but when a library gets changed, if in the simple case that there are just like 10 packages depending on it, I can as a maintainer do source code upload for them, but it would be a waste and I risk to include more mistakes in the source code uploads. So I would like to ask for it new, but it's not clear to me if that's something you would like or not.
Well, in most cases we do like bin reviews because mostly many packages have to been rebuilt, and it's easier with bin reviews because then the urgency doesn't matter. So if the package is built, it can migrate to testing. So that's way better for us because it's way shorter waiting time before the packages can migrate. But only, of course, if it's only a rebuild. Sometimes with API changes, there's more.
You said experimental is for packages not suitable for next release. And we have lots of packages unstable, which domain ASCII blocks saying not suitable for next release. Do you think they should be removed and uploaded to experimental instead, or we just have to live with that?
No, I don't think so. Because there are packages, it should be packages that, in the maintainer's opinion, were suitable for release, but he didn't know about the NRC book or something, and now he thinks they are not suitable anymore for release. So it's only at upload time that you decide, of course. If you say, well, after it has been uploaded, it's not suitable anymore for release, it's stupid to remove it from unstable and then upload it again. In the bug tracking system, it should be clear that the package should not be dependent on, because there is an RC bug saying that's not suitable for release.
One of the issues I've come across in trying to get some of my packages in some of the libraries that I maintain migrated into testing is the build deeds. And on some of, let me call them the more esoteric architectures, trying to work out who to kick to get another build deed rescheduled is a bit of a black art. It's not documented very well. So I maintain the libraries, I maintain the packages. I have access to certain architectures, but I don't have access to all the architectures, and I find it really difficult to try and work out how do I get a rebuild rescheduled on one of these esoteric architectures.
Yeah, so, well, wasn't really meant to be, but at the moment, also for rebuilds like givebacks and retries on the build teams, you can mail the release team because Forum also takes care of one of them. But of course, he will only use these things if the package is not built for a long time or something like that. It's not like to be misused, because sometimes there are just issues with the build team that will be solved by the build team maintainer after some days or some time. Which brings me actually to something that maintainers also should do is like look more often why your package doesn't migrate, because sometimes maintainers don't know that their package failed to build, and they don't know that it's just enough to ask for a rebuild or that there is a bug in the package.
Yes. A couple of years ago, I put great excuses in GitHub and had it mailed to me. And doing that on a daily basis is not very much mail to look at, and helps very much with this.
So, no more questions? Maybe some remarks? No? Okay. You can always reach me privately in person or via email, or of course send me